after the group has recorded the block thickness, and you know your glider's identification number for its fence, we're ready to set up the experiment. I want to be in photogate timing mode and timing none. Now, if I need to, I can adjust that by tapping there. Mode, photogate timing, photogate mode none, stop data with the stop button. I'm going to lift up one end of the photogate, one end of the air track, and slide the block underneath it. The supports on the air track are exactly 1 meter apart, and so I now have a triangle where I know the hypotenuse and the height. I'm going to gently place the glider on the air track, making sure that the A edge is pointing downhill and closer to my photogate. I make sure that my glider breaks the beam and does not run into the photogate. Now I want to measure the position of the photogate, the relative position. And so I bring the glider in, holding it at the front edge until it just barely breaks the beam of the photogate. And I can see that either by looking at the light on top of the photogate or looking for the block status on the lab quest. When it's at the position where it just barely breaks, I record that position in my lab notebook or on a piece of paper or on my computer. And then I slide up a set distance, and I'm going to record that position, and the difference between that position and that position is how far my cart accelerates through. I then start the run, and until this lead edge breaks the photogate, the clock doesn't start. So I can get ready. I want to release the photogate without giving it any sort of push. I let go. And I, or somebody else in my group, catches after it's gone completely through the photogate, but before it runs into the end of my air track and shifts everything in the collision. I can then stop the clock and look at my block times in the table mode of the photogate. I want to export that as a text file, and then I'll collect it later on with my thumb drive. I double check that my photogate is at the same place, measuring that position, and then I go back to a different position, measuring that start point, and then I would do the run again through the photogate, catching it before it collides with the end, exporting that data as a text.